Good evening, everyone, and welcome to our 2020-2021 Athletic Awards Ceremony. I wish we could be conducting this ceremony in person, but as we've all grown accustomed to over the last year and a half, we are at the mercy of protocols that have guided and determined our actions and decisions. In this age of COVID, when the phrase unprecedented times has been overused to describe our current status in society, athletics has taken a backseat to the reality of lives that have been disrupted, lives that have been shaken, and unfortunately, lives that have been lost. And while we sympathize with those who have lost and suffered during this pandemic, this ceremony tonight is a time to stop and celebrate. For as we've seen in the past calendar year, the Tigers have been active and highly successful on the fields of play. True, our indoor sports were taken away from us, and for all the basketball, volleyball, and swimming student athletes out there, my heart goes out to you. High school sports is such an important part in the life of a teenager, and it is especially true in the lives of students at the academy. I know those of you who had a season taken away from you this year are frustrated, and as a coach of one of those sports whose seasons was wiped away by the pandemic, I share your frustration and your pain. But I do know this about sports. It rewards those who are ready. Shakespeare famously wrote in Hamlet that the readiness is all, and dealing with COVID has certainly raised our level of readiness, but it has also forced us to practice patience and to wait. Many athletes by nature are instinctive, and waiting is not necessarily an easy task for them. But we've had to wait. Wait to return to in-person classes. Wait for stores and restaurants to reopen. Wait for restrictions to be lifted. And wait for state, city, and league clearance to begin athletics. It's been difficult for players, coaches, parents, and anyone else involved in interscholastic sports. We waited, and more importantly, we prepared and stayed ready. And in the case of the teams that were able to compete this year, we were richly rewarded. Some of our teams were rewarded with championships and fantastic seasons, but at the end of the day, this year wasn't about wins and losses. It was about competing and just getting back out onto the fields, the tennis courts, and the golf courses with classmates, friends, coaches, and opponents. Our Tigers were ready, and when the chance to compete was put in front of them, they pounced. In the fall, we were inspired by the play of two championship soccer teams and a girls' tennis team that lost its top two singles players but still battled in each of its matches. And then after a dormant winter when none of our student athletes were permitted to play indoor sports, our Tigers were ready again. And we came to life in the spring and were treated to a championship softball season, baseball and lacrosse teams reaching their league title games, and tennis and golf teams battling and pulling upsets on the courts and courses. Of course, perhaps the toughest part of this entire athletic year was experienced by our parents, families, faculty, and fans not being allowed to attend our games. I know I speak for many of our parents who were forced to watch from their cars in the parking lot, or, if you can believe it, from the fence along Toad Hill Road, when I say that games aren't the same without fans on the sideline. Yes, our student athletes dealt with limited schedules and too many games against Long Island opponents, but those of you who did get to play, be thankful, because your parents were the ones who truly lost out on being there to support you, to watch the sports you play with such passion. Like you, they were ready, ready to cheer and support, but they had to cheer from a distance. So I want to thank you, parents, for your patience, your support, and your understanding this year. I will say that I miss seeing you on the sidelines, and I know your kids miss seeing you there too. Let's hope that next year everyone is back to where they are supposed to be, watching the Tigers do what they do best. I am so proud of all of our student athletes and coaches and all of their accomplishments this year. Just making it through a year wearing masks while sprinting on the soccer and lacrosse fields, hitting forehands from the baseline, going from first to third on the base paths, or barking instructions to your players is an accomplishment in itself. But hey, I hope we can say that this whole experience has made us stronger. And however you or I may measure success in athletics, I hope we can all agree that this year was truly a success. Forget the fact that 3 of the 8 teams that competed this year won championships. The fact that we got through the year and played the vast majority of our scheduled games is an incredible victory. Now, I hope to never get into the habit of saying that just competing is a victory itself, but we all know that this year has been different. I'm certainly done with these unprecedented times. Bring on the old precedented times for me next year. I can't wait to see all of our Tiger student athletes competing on the fields of play next year. We will be ready for the challenges that come from not having had a traditional season this year. We'll be ready to assume the role as captains, team leaders, role players, and great teammates. And most importantly, we will continue to prove that despite our size, Staten Island Academy is ready to reassert itself as one of the top schools in independent athletics in New York. With that, I'd like to invite you all to listen to some words from our coaches. Each of our coaches has a unique coaching style, and I'm sure some of them try to model themselves after some of the most legendary coaches in athletics history. And I'm sure that they will inspire and entertain you in the same way that a Vince Lombardi, a Mike Krzyzewski, or a Tara Vanderveer might. So with that, I'll let the coaches take the program from here, and each will speak about their team and season, and also let us know who their two award winners are from their respective teams. Take it away, coaches.
Hey, girls. I hope everyone's well. Let me start by telling you how proud I am of all of you. The way you trained and your gameplay during COVID and its procedures. I know it wasn't easy, especially being on the field all the time with the mask on. You girls did a wonderful job. And it showed, especially when we went up to Portlandge. You girls all took the field as a unit. You played with purpose. You showed them what kind of team you are. You played well. You demonstrated respect, sportsmanship on the field, and you can't ask for more than that. I considered that game to be our PSAA championship, and I have a feeling this season coming, that will be our PSAA championship. Looking forward to the upcoming season. I can't wait to get you girls out on the field, start training, start all over again. I think we're going to have a great year, and I'm expecting a third PSAA championship to come our way. We're going to give out two awards this season. One is the Coach's Award, and the other one is the MVP. The Coach's Award is going to go to a player who I believe will lead us into a great season. She always gives 100% in games, in practices. She's always ready to play. I'm expecting a lot from her this season, and I think she can deliver. Eleni De La Cruz. Eleni, congratulations. The next award is the MVP, which is going to go to a player that there's no denying her talent. She has great leadership, has ability to see the field and make excellent decisions. She's a very special player. That will be very missed. And that's going to Liz Gallagher. Liz, I wish you the best in your next chapter of your life. And I know you'll do great things in college. We look forward to seeing you play. With that being said, girls, I look forward to training. I look forward to our upcoming season. Until then, be well, be safe.
What a year. Pandemic, the uncertainty with school, the uncertainty with athletics. Thanks for the hard work at Staten Island Academy, Mr. Mizell and the athletic department. We were able to get a 6-game season. We got a late start in September instead of August this year. Then we go out there and early on, poor Matt's got to blow out his knee. We had a lot of trips out to Long Island on the bus. We were a little shaky to start. I guess maybe the uncertainty, playing with the masks. We couldn't be more proud of you as far as that went. When push came to shove, you guys showed up. I think it's a lot to do with our senior leadership we had on the team this year with you guys. Great group of kids. And then very nice to get to the final and win it all again. 2 years in a row. Set a lot of expectations for the guys coming along. I look forward to seeing you guys back up at school. My coach's award winners this year are Jay and Quessy. I want to wish all the boys the best going off to college and hope to see you soon. All right, guys, stay in touch and enjoy your summer.
This is Mayuko for the girls' tennis team. With the pandemic this year, we had a short season. But I want to thank school and the league for letting us play. And huge thanks to all the girls who came out to play. This year, me and Mr. DeGrado decided to give out two coaches award. The first coaches award goes to Lana Wine. She was on my team for 6 years. Unfortunately, she got hurt this year. But she was a huge part of the team for the last 5 years, helping us bring in championships. I cannot believe the little Lana graduating high school and going to college. I wish you best of the best and hope you get to play tennis a little bit in the college. Second coach's award goes to Isabella Marchese. I'm so lucky to meet her this year. What a competitor, what a leader. She never played tennis before. She only had 2 weeks to play her first match. She did great and it was fun to watch her. I wish I have a few more years to see what kind of tennis player she can be. Isabella, I wish you the best and come back to me anytime you want to play tennis. I hope pandemic will be over and I see everybody in the season next year. Until then, stay healthy and safe. Have a great summer. Bye.
Hey guys, now this was a tough year with a late start to the season, but all of you handled it well and everyone contributed to the team in a really meaningful way. I really appreciate the veteran guys stepping up and some of the younger players really proved an asset this year. Everyone came together for a great season, but we just ran up against a good team in the end. You should all be proud of what we accomplished both on and off the court. I'm certainly proud of everyone for their fight this year and giving it their all. I want to especially recognize the seniors, Chris Bragna and Frankie Pizzolatto, for their continued efforts. They will certainly be missed next year, but we have a lot of younger players coming in, really looking to fill their positions, and hopefully we can compete for the year-end championship. I'm looking forward to seeing everyone on court next year, and hopefully have a great summer.
What's going on, SAA Athletic Community? It's your golf coach, Paul Blanchard. I'd like to thank and bid farewell to my seniors, Alec Lorza, Nick Falcone, Zevi Magenheim, Justin Selznick, and Steve DeVito. You guys all came out and played a couple matches this year. Huge thanks to you guys. I'll miss you. I know you called me. You gave me a lot of headaches over the season, but the laughs and memories we shared, I'll remember those for a lifetime. So thank you guys a lot. Also great to see a lot of new golfers take strong interest in the game. Guys like Charlie Crane, Sal Cassio, Alex Emmanuel, Andrew Anacharico, the promise you guys show for next year and just throughout your life for just playing golf and taking a huge interest, getting bit by the golf bug is great to see. So thank you guys too. Also huge respect to Lily's Wisney, playing from the men's tees and consistently being either our best golfer or one of the best golfers on the team. It's not easy to do, you know, but she's really good. So gotta give her a lot of respect for that. And I know there's a lot of people I didn't get to bring to the matches. Not that many opportunities. We only had a handful of matches. We did win one, but when we get more next year, I'll get to bring hopefully as many people as I can. So those guys waiting in the stable who are just starting picking up the game this year, can't wait to see you guys on the course next year. With that being said, I'd like to give out my awards. MVP will go to Alec Lorza. He was consistently our best golfer or in the top two every time, so huge respect to him and love to see him continue to be great at the game. And my coach's award to Nick Falcone, who was consistent in coming to every match, could always count on him. Didn't have to worry about whether he was coming or not. I know that he likes to joke around too, but a great guy on the course too. Fun to talk with. Coach's award gotta go to Nick Falcone. Thank you very much.
Good evening, everyone. I hope you're all enjoying the awards ceremony. I'd like to offer my congratulations to the graduating seniors of Staten Island Academy, especially our two baseball players, Danny Saputo and Alan Bobert. I'd also like to offer congratulations to the baseball team as a whole for their excellent season, reaching the PSAA championship game. Came up a little bit short at the end, but it's nothing that we can't fix next year. We chose two MVPs for our awards. It was a very tough decision. We have a lot of talented players and, you know, a lot of thought went into, you know, our choices for the awards. Joe, would you like to start our first one?
Sure. Our first MVP goes to Danny Cost. Offensively, what could I say? The sky's the absolute limit for you. I mean, as Joe and I have discussed, you were absolutely tearing the cover off the baseball this year. I mean, every time I looked up, you were either standing on second base or hitting a home run. You also developed a great eye, too, with the plate. And you probably led the team with on-base percentage this year as well. Defensively, you did a great job in center field. You have a wonderful arm, and you get tremendous reads off the bat. And pitching, you also did a great job. Joe and I couldn't have asked for any more from you this season.
And thank you, Joe. And our second MVP is going to go to Troy Battleman. He had an excellent year on the mound and an excellent year in the field, wherever I asked him to play, whether it was shortstop, center field, spent some time at third base. He had an excellent year. And, you know, I look forward to him leading the team next year and developing into an excellent college baseball player. I want to wish everybody a nice summer. And I hope you enjoy the rest of this award ceremony.
Have a good night.
Have a good night.
Hi, everybody. This is Chris Bruno, the girls varsity softball coach, here to talk about the season. The girls varsity softball team this year was comprised of 13 different players, ranging from freshmen to seniors. We had two senior captains, Madeline Dawson, 4-year varsity player, and Ashley Schmidt, a 3-year varsity player, as well as Bridget Motley in her second season as a varsity player. Those are our captains this year. We had a great group of players that had a combination of new and veteran experience on the team. And we just had a really good blend of players that led to great team chemistry and the ability to be able to work well with each other. It was one of my favorite teams to coach at my time here at the Academy, because everyone just worked and had fun. And it was just a reminder of how important athletics is and playing a sport here at the Academy is. Really, really glad we were able to get back onto the diamond this season. And we were fortunate enough to capture our league's regular season and postseason championship for the first time since 2015. The success on the field is important, but their success in the classroom as well as off the field as citizens of the community is something that I truly respect, and I'm glad to have worked with a group of girls that do this all the time on this campus. So now to the awards for the girls varsity softball team. My coach's award this year is going to Olivia Schmidt. Olivia played any position from catcher to pitcher. She played second base, and she played the outfield for us as well. Type of player that will do anything to help the team be successful. And for me, she was my coach's award winner this year. And for me, my most valuable player is Bridget Motley. Bridget batted 760 in the league this year. On base percentage was over 800. And she hit a team-leading 9 home runs during the season, the most home runs players hit in my time as a coach here at the Academy. Just a leader on the field, encouraging to other girls, helping those that maybe are a little less experienced with softball each and every practice, and a dedicated player to the team. So my two awards, Olivia Coach's Award and Bridget Motley, most valuable player.
The varsity lacrosse team operates by two simple principles: make yourself better and make your teammates better. We talk about these two ideas daily, and they are central to everything we do. And after almost 30 years at the helm, I cannot remember a team that so embodied these ideas so well as did the 2021 team. Needless to say, this was an unusual year. We battled the extended cold, close contacts, and quarantines. We combined the varsity and JV rosters, elected five captains, played 6 games in 9 days during one stretch, and accumulated more bruises than I can remember. We also started 0-4. Why, you ask? Perhaps it was losing the 2020 season. Maybe it was inexperience. The inability to field a full squad in early April was definitely a factor, and some might say we just needed time. While I have weighed all of those things, I would rather point to our mantra, make yourselves and your teammates better, because in the end, that's ultimately what we did. We improved dramatically, taking our opponents and ourselves by surprise. Along the way, there's no doubt that the Taylor Swift-filled bus rides and a little cake helped as well. After a heartbreaking loss, overtime loss to Stony Brook, we made a breakthrough, ending the year on a 5-2 run. Along the way, we defeated Long Island Lutheran twice, a first in program history, avenged a loss to Stony Brook, raised our average goals scored, and reduced our average goals allowed. I cannot point to one person. This was a team effort, and it seemed as if different people rose to the challenge in each game. We entered the playoffs as the third seed, scored an upset victory over Stony Brook on the road by neutralizing their 3 scores and advanced the championship game. Unfortunately, we faltered in the finals, playing an unrepresentative game, but never quitting on ourselves or our teammates. We made the strides that we did by learning to trust ourselves and by learning to trust one another. We held on to that idea for a full 50 minutes that day. The program is in good hands going forward, and we will return a talented and more experienced set of players in 2022. And with that, I want to pay tribute to our seniors. First to Simone Dutton. It took courage to rejoin lacrosse after a 2-year hiatus, and you worked as hard as anyone to get better. Olivia Lombardo, you were a rock on the field. Steady, knowledgeable, and determined, you anchored our defense and solidified our group of defenders. To our league all-stars, Liz Gallagher and Lana Wine, you were a dynamic duo on the field, striking fear into the hearts of our opponents with your speed and physicality. All of our opponents had to account for numbers 15 and 22. To Megan and Isabella, Mr. Aquilano and I have selected you to receive the Captain's Award. Why, you ask? Because through thick and thin, you knitted us together. You were our vocal leaders on and off the field. And you were at the core of all of our efforts. Of course, that leaves Heather. Unfortunately, as coaches, we are limited in the number of awards we can give. But I do not want Heather's efforts and significance to go unnoticed. It's not a coincidence that we started our winning ways when Heather's quarantine ended. With that in mind, I want to bestow a special, unsanctioned, and one-time award to Heather, our difference maker. Heather, on behalf of Mr. Aquilano and myself, I hope you will accept this small token of our esteem, because in 2021, you made a difference in the second half of the season. In fact, some people would say the difference. Thanks to you, Heather, thanks to our other seniors, Simone, Olivia, Liz, Lana, Megan, and Isabella, and thanks to the entire team for an exciting and successful season. See you in 2022.
Thank you to all of our coaches for your season reviews and insights. The problem with putting together a program like this when everything is coming in piecemeal and being cobbled together for video is that I don't even know what I'm following. I can only assume that our devoted coaching staff gave brilliant reviews of their teams and seasons. Then again, some of them might have waited until the last minute, ad-libbed and winged it, or just have spoken from the heart. Either way, I'm sure they were memorable. And at this point, I do want to give a heartfelt thanks to all of our coaches and staff. Your work this year with our student-athletes was incredible, and we were indebted to you for your efforts to keep our kids safe and to juggle rosters and lineups affected by close contacts, extended absences, and quarantines. So thank you to all the members of our coaching staff for all that you've done this past year. And now we get to the heart of tonight's program. And we start this part of our awards presentation by recognizing two of our senior athletes who were honored with nominations for the prestigious Varsity Club Award. This award is given to the top male and female scholar athletes at each high school on Staten Island. And both of these student athletes are going to be recognized for their athletic achievements, their academic ability, and their community service. This year, our nominees were Olivia Lombardo and Dan Saputo. The Varsity Club will announce their winners in a couple of weeks, and I do want to wish both Olivia and Dan good luck, and congratulations to both of you. Staten Island Academy participates in several leagues around New York City and Long Island. Although our main affiliation is with the ACIS, this year we proudly competed in the PSAA League, which was the only independent school league to conduct both the fall and spring season. So despite the three-hour road trips to Stony Brook, Long Island Lutheran, and Portage, we have to consider ourselves lucky to have had other independent schools to compete against. We are proud to recognize PSAA League honors to the following teams and student-athletes, and it should be pointed out that what makes these honors so special is the fact that many of them have been selected by the coaches of the leagues. That means they represent the viewpoint of our opponents and our league representatives, and that is truly a high honor. Being recognized and honored by your competition is one of the greatest tributes a student-athlete can receive. And now, normally I would be calling the following names, and students would be proudly walking onto the stage in the auditorium to accept their awards. So just try to keep that vision in mind as I read the names of and the awards for the following student-athletes and coaches. First, we start with the fall season. In girls' tennis, we competed in both the PSAA and the CHSAA League. We're happy to present the following awards. A plaque to Isabella Marchese for the CHSAA Leadership Award. A plaque to Nicole Rossilli for the CHSAA Coaches Award. A plaque to Yulia Tarnovetska for the CHSAA Sportsmanship Award. And finally, a plaque to Elisa Shapsis for winning the CHSAA Alternate Singles Championship. Congratulations to all four girls. Staying in the fall, we move to the boys' varsity soccer team. And first, we have a plaque for the team for winning the PSAA Postseason Championship, the team's second in a row. And then there are three PSAAA All-Conference selections for the following student-athletes: Quessy Arma, Dan Saputo, and Jeremiah Geneve. And finally, a trophy goes to Dan Saputo for being named the PSAA Postseason Championship MVP. Congratulations, boys. Moving now to the girls' varsity soccer team, who also had a tremendous success this year. The team receives two team plaques, one for the PSAA Regular Season Championship and one for the PSAA Postseason Championship. And for the girls, they are now the two-time defending league champs, having won regular season and postseason titles in back-to-back years. And for individual honors, trophies for being named to the All-Conference team go to Eleni De La Cruz, Allison Gallagher, Liz Gallagher, and Kelly Gallagher. Congratulations, girls. Next, we move to the spring season, since COVID wiped out our winter seasons of basketball and swimming, not to mention our volleyball seasons for both the boys and the girls. We start with the girls' varsity softball team, who put together a fantastic season, winning the PSAA Regular Season Championship and then knocking off Long Island Lutheran in a thrilling come-from-behind victory in the postseason title game at Cantioch Park. The team then receives two plaques, one for the regular season title and one for the postseason championship. Also, earning spots on the PSAA All-Conference team were the following: Ashley Schmidt, Vanessa Cassio, Olivia Schmidt, and Haley Wexler. And finally, winning the league's MVP award for the girls' varsity softball was Bridget Motley. Congratulations to all of our award winners. Moving on to varsity baseball, the Tigers placed three players on the All-Conference team after advancing to the championship game against Long Island Lutheran. First, the team receives a plaque for finishing second in the league and as runner-up in the PSAA postseason championship. And also receiving a trophy for All-Conference honors is Dan Saputo, Dan Kost, and Troy Battleman. Next, we have boys varsity tennis, where three players earned All-Conference honors. Those honors go to Chris Brogna, Joe Donato, and Russell Knorr. And finally, we move to girls lacrosse, which rebounded from an 0-4 start to reel off five wins in their last six games to advance to the PSAA championship. For that team, we have a plaque for being the runner-up in the PSAA postseason championship. And then for individual honors, three girls were named to the All-Conference team: Liz Gallagher, Lana Wine, and Kelly Gallagher. And now for the presentation of the Academy's Special Athletic Awards. Normally, I would be inviting Ms. Crigliano to the stage at this point to hand out the next set of trophies and plaques, but there is no stage, none of these special awards have arrived just yet, and there is no Ms. Crigliano, which may or may not be a good thing for all of us. You know how she gets when there is a camera in front of her and a potential audience listening.
Hey, Mr. Mazzella, sorry to interrupt, but you know I can't resist a moment without a microphone. And of course, to tell you what an amazing job you're doing. I know you love that word, but all kidding aside, I wanted to give a special shout out to our student athletes and our coaches on such a unique but amazing season of championships, wins, and great sportsmanship and flexibility. And a special shout out to our parents who were sequestered to the back parking lot, or even worse, on the side of Toad Hill Road. We really appreciate you. We really love you. And thanks for trusting us and being with us this year. Go Tigers.
As always, the end of the year coaches meeting where we determine the following award winners was intense and filled with lively debate, even though it was held on Microsoft Teams. It was clear to me at this meeting how passionately our coaches feel about our athletes, and all the following awards were determined only after great consideration by the varsity coaches. And it was very difficult to choose some award winners, especially when some student athletes, again, through no fault of their own, had their seasons taken away from them. In some cases, coaches had to do a bit of fantasy sports and imagine how certain kids might have performed if we had had a complete athletic season. So here we go. The following awards are unique to SIA and should be a goal for every single one of our student athletes to strive towards. The Gold A Awards. These are presented to those athletes who have displayed qualities of leadership, spirit, athletic ability, and most importantly, extra effort always. To be eligible, an athlete must have won a varsity letter in two sports prior to this year and must participate on a current team. Selected after a vote of the upper school varsity coaches, this honor may only be received once. Last year, only three juniors received the Gold A, and I'd like to recognize them now before we go any further. Those student athletes are Liz Gallagher, Naima Lindsay, and Dan Saputo. Congratulations to all three of you again for accomplishing that very special feat. This year, the winner of the Gold A Award, and we have seven of them, from the class of 2021, Megan Dix, Jeremiah Geneve, Isabella Marchese, and Ashley Schmidt. And from the class of 2022, Caroline Crodell, Sean Franzreb, and Dan Kost. Congratulations to all of our Gold A winners. Our next two awards are the very prestigious Randall and Hughes Awards. Kay Randall's family had a rich tradition of tennis excellence on Staten Island. Their son Robert played soccer at SIA in the 70s, and Mrs. Randall served as SIA's girls athletic director for several years in the 60s. Her family created this award in 1972 to recognize the girl that best combines the highest standard of athletic ability with true sportsmanship. This year's winner, for the second year in a row, is Elizabeth Gallagher. The Hughes Award was created by Captain and Mrs. William Hughes, the first award being presented in 1963. This award is presented to that boy who has exhibited an outstanding sense of fair play, sportsmanship, qualities of leadership, and athletic ability. This year's winner is Dan Saputo. Congratulations to both Liz and to Dan. Our final award of the evening is presented to our Athlete of the Year. Not surprisingly, we had a number of worthy candidates who were nominated this year, but one was just a notch or two above the rest. This was just another one of the tough decisions our group of academy coaches had to make. But again, I think that speaks to the caliber of student athletes that we've seen this year. The 2020-2021 Athlete of the Year Award goes to a dominant performer who led her team to a regular season and postseason championship during the fall and a berth in another sports championship game during the spring. She's a quiet but fierce competitor and one of the most special student athletes we've seen here at the Academy. When I first met her when she was in 7th or 8th grade just exploring the possibility of coming to SIA, I could not have known how much she would have transformed our girls' soccer program years later. And as we saw this year too, our girls' lacrosse team. She was a game changer on the soccer field as a freshman, and during her 4-year varsity career, she established herself as a top goal scorer in academy history. Not surprisingly, she will take her soccer talents and compete at the Division I level for Loyola University in Maryland. We wish her the best of luck in her collegiate career, and I think we all know that she will do great things at Loyola. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to announce Elizabeth Gallagher as the 2020-2021 Athlete of the Year. Now, before we end, I want to give a big thank you to a few people who have contributed so much to our athletic program and its success. As always, the kids come first. We had a number of students try new sports when their preferred sport was not going to run this year. And we even had student athletes somehow managing to participate on three teams this year, by competing in soccer in the fall and on both the baseball and golf teams in the spring. So to all the student athletes out there, whether you play one, two, or three sports, I say thank you. Thanks again to our parents and our coaches, and a special thank you to Mr. F for his help and guidance this year, and a very special thanks to Jamie Cantor, who helped make this video possible, and who once again assisted all of our student athletes who like to keep her busy by bruising bones and muscles, twisting ankles, and spraining ligaments and joints. As always, we are in good hands with Jamie. In closing, I want to encourage all the student athletes out there to work on our skills over the summer. Make the most of your time so that you can come back next year as better players than you are now. Work on your weaknesses. Don't just practice what comes easily to you. And remember that the only way to make big improvements as an athlete is to make the smallest improvements each and every day. When you do practice, practice hard and practice the right way. And finally, I hate to end with another COVID reference, but if anything, perhaps the interrupted and incomplete seasons we had to play this year have forced us to take stock and inventory of how much we all love sports. When something you love is taken away from you, you can't help but love it all the more. So I hope that this health crisis can help enhance or reignite your passion to play and compete. Let it allow you to fall in love again with the sport, to commit yourself to a team, and to enjoy playing to the best of your ability every time out on the fields and courts. That love and passion for sport is a hallmark of the Staten Island Academy student athlete, and I laugh at the so-called athletes who talk about embracing the grind. Playing sports isn't a grind. It never has been, it never will be. You should enjoy every moment you are part of a team, every opportunity to jump for a spike, to dive into that pool, to sprint up and down the field or court, to defend, and to spend all the energy you have in the pursuit of excellence. Because when the time comes for you to hang up your cleats or sneakers, I'm pretty sure that you'll miss the competition and the camaraderie. I look forward to watching all of you next year as we prepare for another great year of Tiger Athletics. Thank you again, and please have a great summer. Thank you.
cut these corners.